The National Map is a collection of mapping products and services produced by the USGS National Geospatial Program. The products and services are accessed via the internet through service calls and graphical user interfaces. The National Geospatial Program has released a series of how-to videos for people who are working with the National Map data and services. The videos show how to use the services and interfaces to access data and tools for viewing, analyzing, and printing geospatial data. The training materials are a mixture of video and PowerPoint-based lessons. Lessons 1 and 2 serve as an introduction to the training materials. The remaining lessons are designed as quick how-tos and may be viewed as needed in any order depending on the user. Lesson 15C, Introduction to the National Hydrography Dataset. This lesson will provide a brief overview of the National Hydrography Dataset, describe what features make up NHD, show how NHD functions as a national hydrographic network, and provide information on accessing data and additional resources. The National Hydrography Dataset, or NHD, is a digital geospatial dataset that includes the surface water features within the United States. It is one of three hydrographic dataset components of the National Map. NHD is closely related to the Watershed Boundary Dataset and the NHD Plus layer, but this lesson will focus on the background, content, and access to NHD. The other hydrographic datasets have their own lessons. Lessons 15A covers Watershed Boundary Dataset, and Lesson 15B covers NHD Plus. NHD and other hydrographic datasets support numerous science applications at the USGS and other organizations. These include ecological flows, drought, flooding, spill response, stream stats, modeling and prediction, watershed condition reporting and analysis, resource reporting and analysis, and more. In addition, NHD serves as the national network and database for surface water features. All National Map data are available in the public domain for users outside the USGS. In 2016, the USGS released a report on the Hydrography Requirements and Benefits Study, abbreviated HRBS. HRBS was initiated to review and understand current and future user requirements and the associated benefits for improving hydro data. An online questionnaire was completed by over 500 USGS hydrography data users from local, state, federal, tribal, nonprofit, and private sector organizations. This image shows some details on the current and potential benefits that can be realized from hydro data. More information on HRBS plus access to the complete report can be found on the National Map homepage. NHD represents the nation's surface water drainage network and related features. These features include rivers and streams, canals, lakes and ponds, coastlines, dams, glaciers, and marshes as seen here. Note that lake features contain artificial flow path features. These permit hydro network connectivity to be maintained through water bodies. Although other scales are available, the NHD high resolution at a 1 to 24,000 scale or better in some locations is the most up-to-date and detailed hydrography dataset for the nation. This illustration shows the NHD for an area in Colorado, and many of the features found in NHD are labeled. NHD has its origins in the original 1 to 100,000 and 1 to 24,000 scale USGS topographic maps. These maps include numerous hydrography features made up of point features, such as wells, line features, such as stream segments, and area features, including lakes. The topographic map features were later digitized and became digital line graph, or DLG, vector data. The surface water DLGs became the initial version of NHD. These images show a portion of the Lone Pine, California, 1 to 24,000 scale quadrangle. First, you see a topographic map from 1994 and note the blue water feature lines. Next, you can see the digital NHD features as thick blue and green lines. Note how they match the lines on the topographic map. NHD data are being updated, and USGS has processes and tools for updates, but this illustrates the origin of the data. NHD is a vector dataset, and so is composed of point, line, and polygon features. The following images provide some detail on the content included with NHD. This image shows the different features comprising NHD water bodies and NHD flow lines. Flow lines are important line features that represent water channels where flow occurs. NHD water body polygons relate to flow lines by containing artificial path features to enable network connectivity through water bodies. Similar to NHD water bodies are NHD areas. These are also polygon features and they represent landmarks that provide additional detail to water body and flow line features. For example, the inundation area can outline a region subject to periodic flooding that is part of the water body. NHD lines are linear features that are not a part of the flow network. Like the NHD areas, these features provide further descriptive information to the NHD network, in this case NHD flow lines. The NHD line rapid, for example, can be placed congruent to a flow line to show where rapids are found. Many of the NHD features are included for cartographic purposes. Finally, let's look at point features. NHD point features provide further descriptive information. Spring seep is one such feature and can be placed by an NHD flow line or by itself. Some NHD features can be depicted as points or as lines or polygons depending on the size of the feature and the intended data scale. For example, rapids is a point feature as well as an NHD line feature, as mentioned earlier. Certain NHD features can be further subdivided by type, each with its own feature code. This table shows just some of the different types of NHD water body features. In addition to different varieties of different feature types, each feature will include a limited amount of attribution. Complete documentation on NHD data and the earlier content can be found on the NHD website. This includes the NHD feature catalog, NHD feature rules, and the NHD model. We will cover the NHD website shortly. NHD is more than a map. It serves as the National Hydrography Network for mapping and modeling. The NHD network includes flow direction and connectivity upstream, downstream, and through water bodies. The following images show what gives NHD its network capabilities. Characteristics of the NHD network include flow direction. The black arrows show the direction water is flowing. Because of flow direction, now we have the ability to navigate upstream and downstream from any point on the network. NHD flowline features are given a 14-digit reach code. The reach code serves as a unique code for every flowline, regardless of whether the stream is named or not. Any point along the flowline can be identified based on its percentage distance upstream of the end of the segment. This percentage, combined with the reach code, serves as a stream address schema. This addressing capability is known as linear referencing. NHD also has tools to relate outside features to the NHD as events. Together, this means that other data can, in effect, become part of the NHD network, and the interactions of water on these features can be studied. We can see the stream gauge in this Colorado example is now tied to the NHD network. When other features are added as events to NHD, their attribute information is integrated with NHD. This adds geospatial context to the stream flow data and enables a range of applications. This image shows average water flow at the stream gauge, which is information that can be added to NHD at this location. Now we will look at how NHD is stored and provided and other related resources. The area of land between ridges on the land surface that collects all the precipitation that falls in it and drains to a common outlet is called a watershed. The Watershed Boundary Dataset, or WBD, represents the watersheds of the country in 8 nested hierarchical levels, or hydrologic units. This graphic shows large watersheds across the U.S., and note each is given a 2-digit code. Let's focus on the Pacific Northwest Hydrologic Unit Code, Level 1, or HUC 2. Large watersheds can be divided into smaller ones. Each large 2-digit hydrologic unit can be divided into 4-digit units. The Lower Snake is one of the 13 HUC 4s in the Pacific Northwest HUC 2. Each of these can again be subdivided into smaller hydrologic units, now given a 6-digit code, and so forth. This is important to know because NHD is organized and distributed by hydrologic units. Please see Lesson 15A for a more thorough explanation of the watershed boundary dataset. NHD data are provided by 2-digit, 4-digit, and 8-digit hydrologic units. This illustration shows how the 4- and 8-digit units fit within the Pacific Northwest. NHD can also be downloaded by state or for the entire country. This image shows how the flow network and hydrologic units are fully integrated in the National Map dataset. Full details on NHD and access to the data can be found on the NHD homepage. The NHD homepage can be found here. About National Hydrography Data Products provides basic details on medium and high resolution NHD. Access National Hydrography Data Products provides links to accessing NHD. We will visit this page again in a moment. Documentation and Specifications contains links to the NHD User Guide, Feature Catalog, and Feature Rules, among other resources. We mentioned the Feature Catalog earlier in this lesson. Under Resources, Tools has add-on applications designed to work with NHD data. NHD tools are listed here. The tool at the top, Markup Application, allows data users to suggest edits or markups to NHD as well as WBD and NHD plus high resolution. Suggested edits will be reviewed by the USGS and the NHD state stewards before they are approved for incorporation into the NHD and WBD datasets and future NHD plus high resolution refresh products. Stewardship and Community refers to the group of NHD partnering organizations that help maintain NHD content. This page has contact links and information on stewardship. Stewards are local and state and federal groups that assist USGS in updating NHD by applying their expert local knowledge of hydrography conditions in their region to updating geographic and attribute data. And finally, News and Connect have links for NHD points of contact and the NHD newsletters. Now we will show you how to access the NHD data. Click on the Access National Hydrography Product button. People typically either download NHD through the National Map Downloader or directly download via FTP link. This shows the different hydrography datasets that can be downloaded, including NHD plus high resolution and the NHD data discussed in this lesson, and the watershed boundary dataset. You can also see the data extent options for accessing hydrography products based on different hydrologic units. Note that you can use the download viewer to see the different hydrologic unit codes on the screen. This can help you in directly downloading NHD from the direct download links, which will be discussed next. You can see the hydrologic unit codes were within the viewer display. The download viewer provides access to many other USGS datasets beyond NHD. Lesson 3A through 3E provide details on different operations using the viewer. The links shown here provide quick access to NHD. The state and entire nation downloads are self-explanatory, and these allow for rapid access to very large NHD datasets. Downloading by watershed, however, requires you to know the hydrologic unit code for your area of interest. You may need to download the watershed boundary dataset or consult the National Map Downloader, as mentioned, to see these codes. Let's see how the data are presented. Geodatabase is the format typically used for NHD. See the very long list here. All HUC4 units are listed here in numerical order. The compressed data file, XML geodata files, and thumbnail JPEG can be easily downloaded. Again, you will need to know the hydrologic unit code to find the area you want. USGS also makes NHD available through internet map services. This allows NHD data to be displayed using GIS software along with other data layers without needing to download data. Please note that the USGS offers both cached, or tiled, and dynamic map services for NHD. In this lesson, you learned about the National Hydrography Dataset and its content, how NHD functions as the National Hydrographic Network, and methods to access NHD and information on related tools, documentation, news, and contacts.